Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Wednesday, the feast of St. Irenaeus. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. The law of truth was in his mouth. No dishonesty was found on his lips. He walked with me in integrity and peace, and turned many away from evil.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who called the Bishop Saint Irenaeus to confirm the doctrine and the peace of the Church, grant, we pray, through his intercession, that being renewed in faith and charity, we may always be intent on fostering unity and concord. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Genesis. The word of the Lord came to Abram in a vision. Fear not, Abram, I am your shield. I will make your reward very great. But Abram said, O Lord God, what good will your gifts be if I keep on being childless and have as my heir the steward of my house, Eliezer? Abram continued, See, you have given me no offspring, and so one of my servants will be my heir. Then the word of the Lord came to him, No, that one shall not be your heir. Your own issue shall be your heir. He took him outside and said, Look up at the sky and count the stars, if you can. Just so, he added, shall your descendants be. Abram put his faith in the Lord, who credited it to him as an act of righteousness. He then said to him, I am the Lord who brought you from the Ur of the Chaldeans to give you this land as a possession. O Lord God, he asked, how am I to know that I shall possess it? He answered him, Bring me a three-year-old heifer, a three-year-old she-goat, a three-year-old ram, a turtle dove, and a young pigeon. Abram brought him all these, split them in two, and placed each half opposite the other. But the birds he did not cut up. Birds of prey swooped down on the carcasses. But Abram stayed with them. As the sun was about to set, a trance fell upon Abram, and a deep, terrifying darkness enveloped him. When the sun had set and it was dark, there appeared a smoking fire pot and a flaming torch, which passed between those pieces. It was on that occasion that the Lord made a covenant with Abram, saying, To your descendants I give this land, from the Wadi of Egypt to the great river of the Euphrates. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
Give thanks to the Lord, invoke his name. Make known among the nations his deeds. Sing to him, sing his praise, proclaim all his wondrous deeds.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
Glory in his holy name. Rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord. Look to the Lord in his strength. Seek to serve him constantly.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
You descendants of Abraham, his servants, sons of Jacob, his chosen ones, he, the Lord, is our God. Throughout the earth his judgments prevail.
The Lord remembers his covenant forever.
He remembers forever his covenant, which he made binding for 1,000 generations, which he entered into with Abraham and by his oath to Isaac.
The Lord remembers His covenant forever.
Alleluia, Alleluia. Remain in me as I remain in you, says the Lord. Whoever remains in me will bear much fruit. Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Beware of false prophets who come to you in sheep's clothing, but underneath are ravenous wolves. By their fruits you will know them. Do people pick grapes from thorn bushes or figs from thistles? Just so every good tree bears good fruit, and a rotten tree bears bad fruit. A good tree cannot bear bad fruit, nor can a rotten tree bear good fruit. Every tree that does not bear good fruit will be cut down and thrown into the fire. So by their fruits you will know them." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Now today, you have a very powerful gospel, no? Really very, very direct message, so to speak, no? But let me just invite you to reflect on, number one, on the false prophets. So when the Lord says, beware of false prophets, no? And then number two is that, as the Lord said, no, by their fruits you shall know them. So I'd like to say something about what really are the fruits, no? That will in a sense bear witness to the kind of persons we are dealing with, no, so to speak. And then the third and last point is that when you read through this gospel, no, and you say that a good tree cannot bear bad fruit, and there's something very much associated with it, no. Remember the saying, the apple does not fall far from the tree, or in Filipino, kuning puno siyang bunga. No, I'd like to make a comment on that, no, that I don't think that is the meaning of the gospel, no, as we very often really also think about, no. So let's take a look at the three points for reflection. Number one, the false prophets. Beware of false prophets. I think to appreciate the warning of the Lord, we need to go back to the meaning of the prophet. What is the role of the prophet, no? I think the role of the prophet, you must recall, is every time the community, you know, the people were veering away from God's plan or the relationship with God, the prophet will call them to task. They will remind them, no? Whoop, we're veering away. Nalilihis tayo ng landa, so to speak. No, we're veering away from our relationship with God. So that is the role of the prophet, no? It is to lead us back to God, no? Every time we sort of go in the wrong path, no? And so the false prophet is someone who leads us away from God, no? Either by attracting us to material things or to false promises, confusing us. So these are false prophets, no? And very often they cause so much division in the community also, no? In the same way that a genuine prophet does, no? But a false prophet divides the community to bring the community away from God, to prevent the community from doing what God wants them to do, no? So I think that's a very important point to remember, no? Beware of false prophets, no? And I think this is really looking at people who lead us away, no, from our relationship with God. And of course, the danger is also people who really put themselves at the center and not lead people to God, but to themselves. No, really, it is a narcissistic predisposition, no, of these false prophets. No, maybe that first point. No, and there are people around. I think you can see them. No, you can look at them. You can spot them, so to speak. No, so beware of false prophets who lead us away from God. And then the second point is about by their fruits you shall know them. You know, more and more, I think I mentioned this in previous masses, especially during this Lenten and Easter season. You know, I know we've always talked about it, we said it, but no, it's really now this last year that I really felt, no? I felt that all loving faith, hope, and love must bear fruit in service. That if we are genuinely loving, it must bear fruit in service. So that second point to reflect on. Are the fruits of our faith, of our hope, of our love, are the fruits, really fruits of service. And then the third and last point is that, we say a lot, no, by that the good tree will bear good fruit. A rotten tree cannot bear good fruit, no? Here, I think it's important to sort of qualify that. It's not just that we're sort of trapped, no? By the fruit, the apple does not fall far from the tree, no? Sometimes that becomes a very judgmental comment, no? But I think what we need to bear in mind is that what is important, and I'm now again talking from the perspective of a teacher, no? How do we form young people? Of course, we say, no, there must be a very positive environment, no? The environment must be the good tree. But in the end, they must make their choice, no? And I think our role is to give people enough knowledge, enough formation to make good choices. But we must give them an environment where they have the freedom to choose. And an environment that will guide them to make the right choices, no? But never can we impose on them. I think that's very, very important. That's why I think what a good way of looking at the message of the Lord is that we may become people worthy of emulation. We must become good role models so that our younger people, the people that we influence, will bear good fruit. No, but in the end, remember, they must make the choice. We cannot make the choice for them, and we cannot impose it on them. You know, I always say that virtue, values can never be imposed, but they can be modeled. We can serve as examples, and hoping that we will inspire others for them to desire to have these values, to embrace these values, and to emulate, no, the living out of these values and virtues. The third point, no? Siguro maganda na pagnilaya natin to. Napakaganda ng ebanghelyo nga, napakalinaw, no? Napakadirekto, no? Sabi niya, mag-ingat kayo sa mga huwad na propeta. Tandaan natin yung propeta, ang siyang nagpapaalala sa atin pag nalilihis tayo ng landas sa ating relasyon sa Diyos. Kaya siya ay nagbabalik sa atin sa relasyon natin sa Diyos, no? Sa ugnayan natin sa Diyos. Kaya ang huwad na propeta ay ang naglalayo sa atin sa Diyos. At kadalasan makikita natin itong mga propetang ito ay dinadala nila ang atensyon, no, at ang paghanga sa kanilang mga sarili, no. Sabi nga natin ito yung mga narcissistic, no. Ito yung mga napaka self-centered, no. And these are the false prophets leading us away, you know. Nilalayo tayo sa ating relasyon sa Diyos. At yung pangalawang punto ng pagninila ay sabi nga, 'di ba, na makikilala tayo sa ating mga bunga. At nais ko lang mungkahin, no, na ang tamang bunga ng ating pananampalataya, ng ating pag-asa at ng ating pag-ibig ay paglilingkod. Ako kumbinsido, no, na lahat dapat ay nagbubunga sa paglilingkod. Yung pangalawang punto ng pagninilay. At yung pangatlo, tuling punto ng pagninilay, di ba, sabi nga, di ba, na ito nga sabi na ang isang mabuting puno ay magbubunga ng mabuting prutas o bunga, no? Ang masama o bulok na puno, hindi yan magbubunga ng magandang bunga. Pero dito mahalaga makita natin na ano nga ba ang mabuting puno? Ang mabuting puno ay ang nagtuturo, nagbibigay ng halimbawa sa kanya mga miyembro, lalong-lalo na sa kabataan. Ako nga bilang isang guro, yun yung malinaw sa akin, eh. Kailangan magbigay tayo ng maraming ehemplo, maraming modelo sa ating kabataan na nagsasabuhay ng magandang pagpapahalaga, magandang mga birtud, mga katangian, at sana ay mabigyan inspirasyon, ano, na tumulad sila sa mga ganitong mga ehemplo. Sa tingin ko, yun yung isa sa mga turo ng ebanghelyo ngayong araw, na tayo ay maging mga mabuting huwaran, maging mabuting ehemplo, upang naisin, ano, ng ating mga kabataan, ng ating kasama sa komunidad, na mahalin tulad sa mga mabuting asal at mabuting mga masasabi natin na pagpapahalaga ng ating buhay. Dasalin natin ngayon ito na sana ay tayo ay maging mga maging mga mabunga at mga alagad ng Diyos na tunay na maglilingkod, alagad ng Diyos na magiging ehemplo sa ating kapwa. May we bear fruit in service, and may we become role models worthy of emulation by the people we work with and live with. Jesus' death and resurrection has borne for us life-giving fruits. Through our prayers, may we as modern prophets give good fruits for the church and the world.
That the church may lead the Christian faithful to the road that leads to the values of love, justice, and truth, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our poor people may not be exploited or misled by false and ambitious leaders, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That people who are victims of injustice may be healed and learn again to develop trust and friendship, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember also in our prayers all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. And we pray in a very special way today for Capitan Henny Lopez, the founder of ABS. Let us pray. Today is his death anniversary. And let us pray that the Lord may continue to welcome him in his presence, and that where he is, that he may continue to pray for our country and for ABS. And let's also pray for our brother and sister Muslims as they celebrate one of their two great feasts, no, the Eid al-Adha. Let us pray that they may have a very solemn celebration and a very festive celebration also. No? For this, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the sacrifice we offer you with joy on the heavenly birthday of Saint Irenaeus bring you glory, O Lord, and instill in us a love of the truth, so that you may keep the church's faith inviolate and her unity secure. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the blood of your blessed martyr Irenaeus poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness. And so, with the powers of heaven, we sing, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. We remember most especially our brother Henny and all those who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Irenaeus, the martyrs, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now let us offer our prayer of humble faith and hope.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we humbly come before you in faith and hope. Grant us your grace and guidance as we emerge from this pandemic. We thank you for the blessings that saw us through the challenges of the past years. Reward those who selflessly served and continue to serve our many needs. Console those who suffered. Heal the sick. Grant eternal rest to those who died. May we draw inspiration from our collective and individual experiences. Let our hearts burn within us to build a world closer to your kingdom of justice, truth, equality, peace, joy, faith, hope, compassion, and love. May each of us be a bright candle to remind us that the light will overcome darkness and never the other way around. We pray for our nation. Give us the courage and inspiration to relentlessly take part in the project of building a nation that our founding fathers envisioned over a century ago, and to which succeeding generations offered their lives in dedicated service, some to the point of martyrdom. Heroes, also Filipinos, may continue to work for freedom and someday truly be free. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception, Patroness of the Philippines,
pray for us.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us. And let us pray. Through these sacred mysteries we pray, O Lord, give us in your compassion an increase of that faith which brought glory to the Bishop Saint Irenaeus, as he maintained it even until death, and may the same faith bring to us who truly follow it justification in your sight, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless us, the Father, and to the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat and happy fiesta sa ating mga kapatid na mga Muslim. At again, we'd like to ask for your prayers for Kapitan Henry Lopez as we commemorate his death anniversary. Maraming pong salamat and let's have a good break today. Thank you.
Kapatid, nakikita naman natin kung gaano kaganda itong area ng NED. Sa darating na mga taon, ito po ay mawawala dahil cover po ito ng coal mining area. So napakalungkot isipin. Ngayon lang natin ito makikita sa susunod na mga araw, sa susunod na mga taon. Mawawala na ito. Hindi na ito makikita ng ating mga kabataan dahil lang sa kagustuhang minahin, kunin yung carbon, yung coal sa lugar na ito. Gamitin ng mga makapangyarihan, mga mayayaman dito sa ating bansa. Kaya kami po ay nananawagan sa Diocese of Marbel. Tulungan po kami sa aming kumpanya dito sa NED Lexington.